good standard today. As we get our first origins of words of the week, I'm tempted to put you in the spot and make you do after talking about why you're shade of pale. Fandango.
I've made a note. I will come to that.
That's not good enough, Susie. I want a full description of Fandango before the week is out.
Okay, you're welcome. So I'm going to actually base most of my origins this week on emails from viewers. I'm from you, Colin. And today's comes from Karen Joseph. And you know that my first love is German, so I particularly relish this question. Karen says, I believe there's a word in German for the patterns you can see behind your eyelids when your eyes are closed. She says she keeps searching. She's asked German-speaking friends, but she's not managed to find it. Karen, I think what you were thinking of is the German Eigengrau, which means intrinsic grey, because when we are in perfect darkness, whether or not our eyes are closed, we see the light almost as grey, or the absence of light as grey, and little sort of grey black and white spots as well, and lots of scientific experiments have been done into this. So Eigengrau or Eigenlicht, which is intrinsic light. So we never see perfect black, I think, is the idea in this. So Karen, I hope that's what you were thinking of, but it gives me a chance to talk about some of my favourite German words, which do also fill a gap, you know, when we don't have the right word in English. One that I discovered quite recently, which I love, if loneliness is Einsamkeit, which means oneness. But apparently if you feel alone, even in a couple, that's Zweisamkeit, so that you put a zwei for two in there. But it can also mean when you're in a couple and you don't need anyone else. It's kind of got a double meaning. The wonderful solitude that you feel below a canopy of trees if you're walking in a forest. Waldeinsamkeit, which is forest solitude, which I think is beautiful. And finally, one that came out during the pandemic. You know, we all witnessed fisticuffs around the toilet roll aisles. They have a word, Hamsterkauf, which means hamster buying. And it's not just panic buying, but it's also hoarding everything at home in case there'll be a shortage later. And it's hamster buying, obviously, because the rodent stores everything in its cheeks in case it needs it later. Very good. I love that one, hamster buying.
Right, Joel's hoping not to fade the grey here. The gap is 13 points. We have four rounds left, and it's letters first, and Joel, you're picking.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Joel. T.